So after just one class on scary obstacles, I would expect everyone to be doing this at the end of the class. So to finish up this little thing, like I said, I promised I wouldn't keep you too long. I have a little poem I'm going to recite for you.
Oh my God, I love him.
It goes like this. If you're breaking out a Bronco, you better get him slicker broke. For some time you'll have to try it when it isn't any joke. When the wind begins to blow him till it snaps his mane and tail, and you see a dark cloud coming full of lightning, rain, and hail, you know if you step off him that he'll likely pull away. So you try it in the saddle, and you're hoping that you stay. But your horse begins to buck it when you get it halfway on, and your arms and sleeves is tangled. He throws you and he's gone. It's a mighty nasty feeling that a feller can't explain. Standing there bareheaded, plumb helpless in the rain. Your slickers tore and busted. The wind just took your hat. And you watch your horse and saddle go drifting down the flat. It's then you get an ID and you don't forget it, pal. You better slicker break your Bronco in a mighty good corral. That's a poem by a really famous
cowboy.
A guy named Bruce Cascadon wrote that. He lived from like, I don't know, 1880 to about 1950, so he was one of the last real cowboys that saw the range get fenced and all that stuff. And yes, many, many famous poems that pretty much all of my cowboy teachers are prone to launch an into a line or two of a poem like that whenever a subject comes up. So, a couple people asked before we started, and I said I'd tell you at the end. Cosmo is two, coming three. He was ridden for the first time on June 23rd. So today I meant to look at his log, but I think this was 55 or 56 rides today, what you just watched. So he's a two-year-old, and depending on how you want to count, you could either say he's 90 days under saddle or 60 days under saddle, but this is what I do.